Hey mate, I'm Alex.
And I'm Gaston.
Welcome to Power Mates.
This is the place to learn and share about Fabric and Power Platform. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this channel with your friends and colleagues.
So, hey everyone, happy new year. It's that time of the year again, and we couldn't be more excited. Today, we are going to be talking about Fabric Copilot from the administrator perspective. So please, Gaston, can you share with us some of those important aspects?
Yeah, of course, Alex. Let's just start with some information around Copilot for Microsoft Fabric and its own requirements if you are an admin for your tenant in your organization. So before your business or your organization starts leveraging or thinking around Copilot capabilities in Microsoft Fabric, you need to enable Copilot in your tenant. So Copilot, as a big note here, doesn't work for trial versions on Fabric. You need at least F64 or P1 capacity to use Copilot. Remember that when we talk about F64 is the Fabric capacity size. So for those on Power BI Premium, you need at least a P1 capacity or above. And that is a question that I've been answering so far for several clients, colleagues, and community members. So with Copilot and other Gen AI features in preview, Microsoft Fabric brings a new way to transform and analyze data, generate insights, create new visualization, and even start switching and ramping up with new reports in Power BI. So the preview of Copilot in Fabric is rolling out in different waves or stages. So we are hoping to hit that goal before March 2024 and that all the customers with a paid capacity for Fabric, F64 or higher, and recap on that one, Power BI Premium capacity, P1 or higher, have access to the Copilot preview. So it's going to be becoming available for everyone as a new setting in the Fabric admin portal. So when you roll out, when you check on that rollout for this new feature, you're going to see that in your Power admin tenant portal. So when charging begins for the Copilot on Fabric experience, you can count Copilot usage against your existing Fabric. You're going to see that usage as part of your Power BI Premium capacity.
Oh, that is great, Gaston. And can you now share some details on how an admin should enable Copilot in their tenant?
Yeah, of course. Let's head over to my machine and let's take a look on those features. So let's start with our main portal. Remember that all the time, for every single workload across Fabric, you're landing in the same zone, in the same area, in the same homepage, and based on your workload or your personas, you're going to picking up on Power BI workload or Data Factory or Data Activator or Data Engineer. That depends on the work that you will be doing so far in your tenant. But if you are a Power BI or Fabric admin, you're going to go and check in the right corner over there that there's a settings option, and then you can switch to the admin portal under governance and insights. In that portal on the left, you're going to see that there's a whole section that is tenant settings. And at the right, you can go below, almost at the end of these overall options in your tenant settings. I repeat, as a Fabric admin or Power BI admin, you're going to see this section over here. The name is Copilot and Azure OpenAI Service. So if you open both sections, you're going to see that first, you can enable the preview of Copilot and all the features powered by Azure OpenAI. Remember that this is backed by the Azure OpenAI Service. And you can enable these features for the entire tenant or and this is kind of a little bit of best practice here. If you click on this option, you can say, hey, I just create a new Entra AD or Azure Active Directory AD. And with that security group in mind, you can say, hey, I have my Power Mates security group. I want to leverage that security group. And you can keep adding members to that group. So that means that Copilot is going to be enabled only for that security group. Remember, that should be part of the work or the activity that we do in the Azure portal before that. And then this other option, again, doing the same thing. And this is the option to the data sent to the Azure OpenAI and can be processed outside your tenant geography compliance. So in this case, you are enabling Fabric Copilot only for some users, some members on that security group.
I appreciate you showed that process. But then, in the other hand, you know, how I can start really using Copilot as an end user?
Yeah, that's really interesting question. Remember that when we talk so far, a few videos back around Fabric Copilot, you can leverage Copilot for Power BI users or Copilot for data engineers or Copilot for even the context on data flow generation too, or Copilot in the notebooks context. So let's go over to my machine again to showcase the Fabric Power BI report use case and scenario. So in this case, I am sharing a Fabric workspace. Within that Fabric workspace, I'm going to be opening one of the reports that I have in my tenant. And then what I'm going to see is that, of course, this is a preview version of my report. This is a reading version of the report. But if I click the option to edit the report in the service itself, suddenly we have this option that we see right now here, that is Copilot. This option allows me to hit Copilot, and as a first step, I can ask Copilot to suggest new content for this report. As soon as I hit this option, Copilot is going to read the data model, the data set, or the semantic model behind the scenes, and it's allowing me to say, for example, adding a new page for this report with a business area overview based on that semantic model. In this case, I just click on that option and I create a whole new page. As you can see here, Copilot bring a whole metrics for me where this is a summary overview by business area, and I can start switching. And as you can see, Copilot already add some of the key metrics like the amount, the actual, the count of years, where I can start slicing the data back and forth and even adding more visuals, because this is edit model. So if you want to add more DAX measures, if you want to add more metrics, or you need to switch back or remove any of this visual, this is all over the place, and you can start removing pieces and switching things around and adjust this page, even if that was a page created by Copilot so far.
That's really interesting. So can we see same for data flows, Gen2, or notebooks?
You are too anxious, Alex, as usual. Stay tuned, Power Mates, because in our next episodes, we will be covering several use cases to showcase Copilot in the context on data flow generation too, and the context of notebooks within Fabric.
Okay. I'm going to keep waiting on that for sure. So then, Power Mate, that's all for today.
Stay tuned, because for more in-depth insights, tutorials, and exciting news right here on our channel.
As usual, like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and join us on this journey.
As every single end of our videos, together, let's unlock the full potential on Power Platform and Microsoft Fabric.
Yeah.